Humans need to know that we're serious. That we're ready to infiltrate the city centers and strike at their heart. To that effect, we're moving in to take out a high-profile target that will get plenty of people's attention. Especially Advent. Move to lock down the area and eliminate any security forces nearby.
Welcome back to another episode of XCOM 2 Long War 2. Of course, this is going to be the more trying mission where I think from memory we're sending a full squad, and of course, because it was mostly because we had a very low time to actually infiltrate the area, so I can definitely tell you that by then the enemy status is 45, which probably means we're going to be dealing with a lot of mobs, so no doubt this will be an interesting run, and hopefully we can at least, you know, pull out when we need to. But given that, I think it's going to take a while for the Sky Ranger to actually come down, so we've got a bit of a ragtag bunch of people, but we'll just have to see how we go.
Menace 1-5, we have a fix on the target. Move to place the X4 charges at the designated position.
Alright, so everyone is concealed and already this is okay, so let's double check the Sky Ranger. 7 turns. That is going to take a while. So, this is definitely something where you want to be very careful with. So it's a choice of 8, and this is no doubt very fortified. So, I'm just trying to remember if we actually have a shinobi with us, but I don't think that's actually the case. But I do have a technical that, we do have a sniper, so I'll definitely perch him up on that roof. And obviously, and one thing we'll want to do is obviously scope out the area around us just to make sure that there is at least someone close by. So I guess the question is, who do I move with first? And I guess I want to say run and gun. This guy, he's sort of still like, I guess, fairly panicked-ish, so probably not in a good place at the moment. So I guess Jiang, what class are you? I don't actually remember. That's interesting. I don't think that's gonna be too much of a worry. You're probably a grenadier. Yes, you're a grenadier. Alright, that works for me. I suppose I could pop you down there, or I could keep you up here, but then I suppose he's not really blocking anyone else, so we'll keep you up there for now. But hopefully we don't... Okay, we haven't reviewed anyone. That's great. I guess the question is probably to check the map dimensions. Okay, we're in a corner, so there's gonna be, probably won't be any nasty surprises behind us, so we will use this turn to get ourselves into the right places, so especially we'll get our sniper perched up here. I suppose I should send someone to look over this edge just to make sure.
Edit there now.
Okay, so far so good. So we can at least get people into position now. So Jeff, let's get you over here. You're the newer sniper. Maxim, we need to get you in a good place where you can kind of just use your ball caster without too much worry. But of course, we still want to be able to keep people sort of around high up enough to get the aim advantage. So we don't want to move people too far away. I guess the other thing is that the advantage between here and here is that we can call the Sky Ranger down here somewhere in the middle, and we can definitely call it after we engage, so we don't waste the... So that we don't really waste the element of surprise, so to speak. Alright, Maximilian, you're our new gunner. This is no doubt be an interesting turn of events. Okay, so no one underneath us either, which is great. Alright, well, let's get everyone closer to the edge, and we'll put them all on Overwatch, and then that should be kind of a job well done. Maxia.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Ooh, moving on, Leah. Move you closer to the edge.
Position confirmed.
Andre.
Moving to position.
Alright, Overwatch all. Because if one of us gets noticed, then we at least have to have one up on them. Alright, so there seems to be someone up there. Oh boy, that is a lot. They weren't kidding about it being fortified. So, I guess... Obviously, we're not going to have like a good opportunity to really, I guess, get in there, so to speak. So, I'm just trying to think about where I should... I want to move the technical guy close, but we also want to try and trigger them while without triggering anyone else. So So I guess the question is, do we set up or do we attack them now? So I think I'll take the opportunity to push forward with Maximilian.
Closing target position now.
And then we'll see what happens. Okay, so there's just the four. We're hoping they move a bit closer, and we don't want to stray too far from this rooftop either. So we'll get our technical over here, and then they'll give us an idea of our mission range.
On the way.
The one tough thing about the technical is that we need to keep them close enough.
I have eyes on the enemy.
Yeah, because we want to have the technical close enough to be able to use a flamethrower. But we want to keep him far away such that he doesn't really activate any other pods. Alright, so I guess we can start moving other people forward. So I guess the question is like, who or where or how do we place them? Alright, Leah, we can put you here. You've got two grenades, which tells me your aim is probably not that great. And at least this is behind full cover, so I won't have to worry too much. Maria, you've got a shotgun, so you're definitely gonna be in the front.
That's affirmative.
Because we're definitely gonna need I was hoping I didn't activate that civilian. Okay, so this is, you can see four, that's presumably the four of them there, but hopefully not that guy over there. Alright, Maxim. You've got the bolt caster, which makes things a bit interesting, so can definitely move you a bit closer here.
Position now.
And then you could probably open up with a light on up and then follow up with a grenade, so that will actually be a good opportunity. Cypher, Milan, you're good where you are. Maximilian? Nope, you're good. Jiang, you're a grenadier. So I want to be somewhere where you can still sort of be close enough to shoot a grenade. And since you're a grenadier, you can definitely throw a grenade over a larger distance, so just trying to think. The problem is with this goddamn civilian is actually thinking over here. Which is probably good enough.
Moving on target.
We take advantage of the fact that you can throw grenades over a larger distance. Andre, you're a rookie. That means you could be bait or sacrifice material, as much as I hate to put it. I guess we could keep you up here with George for now. With Jeff, sorry.
Roger that.
And then now we put everyone into Overwatch. Alright, they seem to be moving away. What about this particular group? Okay, they're moving away, so this turn we engage. But to do that, we have to move the technical away from the right, because he's the only guy that's actually further out that way. So yeah, I have to move the technical first before we engage, which actually really sucks, but that's probably the best we can do. Alright, can we see them at all? Okay, we can't. So now the question is, how do we engage? And one obvious thing is that obviously when we engage, we want to be able to take out a bunch of them to begin with. So Leah, can you actually see anyone from over there? You probably can't. But you can actually get back up on the roof if you wanted to. However, there's no cover for you, so we'll have to make do with over here.
On the move.
Just double check we can't see the guys on the right. Okay, great. So Leo's on Overwatch. Actually, should I put Leo on Overwatch or should I throw a grenade? Oh, that's a good question I haven't thought of. I guess what we do when we put people into, when we put people into Overwatch, it's gonna be people with good aim, I suppose. This guy we might need the suppression, this guy we definitely need the grenades, but this place is not good. I don't want to push forward that way, because there could be more guys, so just trying to think, from here, how far can you shoot a grenade? You can almost get there, so we actually need to move closer this way. So this is actually, I guess, a little bit better. we'll do that. On the move. And then we have to make sure that we take out anyone who could potentially flank him. Do you hate to take down a bunch of civilians with you? But that's just how it is, I suppose. Okay, who do we put on Overwatch? That's the question. I think Leah I'm gonna put on Overwatch. Because she probably won't get a chance to like, even if she shoots, she might miss. Like, once they scatter, she might not be able to throw a frag grenade, so I can't make use of her in that regard. Maximilian, we could suppress, so we're not gonna overwatch with him. Andre, I can't actually get you down there. And you probably won't be able to throw a grenade, but while you're up on the roof, you have the aim advantage. So we'll make use of that. Maxim, you've got light 'em up, so I want to take advantage of that. And there's one more. Okay, so you've got a shotgun, you could potentially run and gun. So the only thing I need to be careful with is not to go further that way, otherwise it'll be activated. So Alright, that's things figured out. Let's go in.
Fire in the hole.
Oh god, the lag. Okay, I killed two troopers and three civilians, which is not pleasant, but but it is nonetheless a good start. Alright. Sectoid. Miss. That's expected. And a graze. Okay. Alright, so Maxim, you've actually got... Now, these guys are behind the right, which is actually kind of annoying. Because if I move any further than over there, then these guys will activate. So, of course the question is who can I shoot? And who should I try and shoot? And of course, who do I use a grenade on? So, Sergio, you can hit him with a frag, that's great. Maximilian, we can get you a bit closer. But while we've got an easy target with Maxim, just see 19, that's not great. So, Maxim, you shoot him. That's gonna hurt.
Enemy eliminated over here.
And then we'll figure out what to do with Maxim next, once everyone else has taken the turn. So, shotgun.
Moving to position.
36 and a 0. 36 isn't great either. So, 240. Okay, so I think I'm gonna suppress that guy. So we'll see. I can still see him, and I wanna be on this side because of people over on that side. So, or if I could? No. Okay, definitely can't. alright, so, Maxim, can you actually throw a grenade over there? You can! I wonder if I should try that. No, I think reloading the broadcaster is better. So, we'll get Sergei to throw a grenade, because he's got a bunch of stuff that is, he's got a lot of explosives anyway, so he's like, oh yeah, I mean, it's gonna work out well for him anyway. Alright, so you will suppress. Actually, no, I want to see... Who else can I shoot with? Because I'm just thinking, if it's a 40%, it's pretty decent, to be honest. But the other thing I can do is holo target, but he doesn't have the quick holo targeting. I think while I have a shot, I will take a shot now. Okay, that's fine. And basically we'll holo target if we don't have an opportunity or don't have a good opportunity to snipe them. So you're gonna be suppressed.
Bring in the pain.
Maxim, you're gonna reload.
Good to go.
Maria, let's get you over here.
A okay.
I just saw the... Oh man. That was very, very bad timing. I got a bit greedy there. That's one mistake I would not be making. And it didn't even need to happen. Oh god. No, well, apparently the joint activated twice. That's a bit amusing. I'm not sure what happened. Oh, we've got a bunch of zombies. Okay.
That was close.
Okay, this time we need to pull back. We definitely need to pull back.
I'm under fire.
Because we have way too many people. That's we have way too much to deal with. Okay. Okay, moving a bit close for comfort, and you're an Overwatch. Okay. That's not great.
Take a fire over here.
Cool. So many shots. So many misses. That you gonna blow up or not? Alright. Okay, we've got a lot to deal with now. Civilians here. Haven't activated that group yet. I have to keep in mind that we literally have all the time we have in the world to do this. So we should take this as slow as we can. Now, I want to see how far the flamethrower is. Probably not that great. I was wondering if I could use the flamethrower to take out the zombies, but it looks like the zombies are too far away. Alright, I've got frag grenade. And I've got another grenade. I can definitely use another grenade there. Leo, hopefully you can take out someone. You can definitely take out someone with the frag grenade. So the question is, who do I move with first? Okay, light them up. Wow, that aim is shit. But we're gonna take this opportunity to, while we can, to shoot. So, I think I will shoot... The aim is the same, so I want to shoot the zombie that's possibly... I want to shoot the zombie that's further away. It'd be nice if you take him out. Okay, that works.
Target neutralized.
And then, maybe... You could possibly do a flashbang over here. And actually, no, you can. But, yes, you could... No, you can't take out that Overwatch. So, I might leave it to someone else to take out that Overwatch, but we'll see what happens. So, Cypher, you've got a rocket and a flamethrower. I feel like the rocket is actually pretty best used over here. But, I guess... If I move here, I could probably use the flamethrower, which would be pretty sweet. But the problem with that is that I'll be running two Overwatches, and that is way too risky right now. Leo, can you take out this guy with a grenade? No. And the problem is no one can move. Unless they want to be busted by an Overwatch. I'm thinking while these guys are activated, I only see the zombies. Doesn't mean the sectoids over there are activated. Can Leo throw a flashbang that can hit both Overwatches? Yes, you can. Let's do this. Excellent. Now Cypher can move over here and use a flamethrower.
Heading out.
Because we kind of want to try and be flexible, so... Okay, so the flamethrower is not going to hit that guy behind, but that doesn't really matter. It really matters that we hit that officer at the back.
Fired up.
Okay, burning, that means you'll be dead next turn, and that guy is dying. Great. That's that guy back there, which is gonna be annoying. Now, I need to think about taking out this zombie, which is gonna be a bit of a pain. Actually, now that the Overwatchers are out, we can start taking down people. So, Leo, we'll get you moving forward. Now, how... 61, are you serious? I think we can take out this guy at least. Or that guy. Let's see who we can hit with our sniper. Actually, no. Yes, Jeff can hit the zombie. The aim is much better. And he's more likely to kill it in one go. Alright. Maximilian.
Moving on target location.
Of course, you've got bigger and better grenades, so... Can you hit both of them? It would be nice if you killed both of them as well.
Heads down.
Go, Jiang! Yes! Alright.
Multiple hostiles eliminated.
Alright, and then Leah can take out this guy with a grenade. Or should it be that guy? Should probably be that guy, but I don't think I will have the guaranteed kill. He's still disoriented, so it's better. We should kill at least the ones we can, or that is at least more guaranteed to kill, so to speak. Now there's this guy over there. Can I actually see him? Yes. So I'm gonna suppress him because I actually can't reach him. Alright, and Andre, we need to move you forward. Yep.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
I guess you could take a shot if you wanted to. No? Oh, okay. Well, we'll just move you forward some more. And Maximilian, you're going to suppress this guy.
Stay put.
Maxim, of course. Let's get you a bit closer. Because you can at least reload and then fire again if you need to. Over here, over here. Let's put you over here. No longer marked, that's great. I do apologize for the framey footage, it's kind of annoying to be honest. Alright, this is fine, because they'll get a chance to scatter, but they won't actually get a move. If I'm correct. Okay.
Got an advent here.
This one's gonna need a rocket. What's he doing? Alright, taking a shot at the technical, that's fine. Oh, the drone's getting a turn, that sucks. Yeah, they're all getting a turn. That's really crap, actually.
I'm alright! No! What's happening? No! This isn't right! This isn't right!
I can... give it a try!
Okay, so not all of them got a turn, which is great. What's not great is that I have so many to fend off now. Oh boy. Alright, Cypher. So a grenade will be useful in taking out these guys. And then we'll probably do a rocket around there. We need someone to run the Overwatch. This guy needs to be taken out with a frag grenade. So Andre, do we with Andre? This guy is disoriented, he'll probably miss the Overwatch. This guy's on Overwatch. So, worst case scenario, I think Andre would take... Worst case scenario, Andre would take two hits. But it's most likely he'll probably take one at the worst. And with 8 HP, I think it's a risk we take. Oh, wow. He actually got a hit. He actually got hit from the disoriented guy. Alright, 77, 65. So the Overwatches are gone. I do want a flashbang, if possible, on whoever's remaining. So we're gonna see who we can take out first. So Cypher's good. Let's get Andre to take him out with a frag. Just a guaranteed frag. Two? Fuck me. Okay, so let's keep on moving. Don't have too much time to really, I guess, sit around in disbelief. I want to see if our sniper can take down the drone. Please do. Would be very nice. That's not good.
I nicked him.
I have a feeling this is about where your horse about. I guess the other thing I could do is shoot the rocket here, and then we save the grenade for something else. Because I really want the rocket to hit the... Because the drone has to go. There's no doubt about that. You can't run and gun, which is not great. But you... Let's see how far you can throw a grenade first. Okay, so it would be nice if I could get it, if I could get a bit closer. Okay. The problem is if I move here, he can get flanked around, which is not great. But I don't think I can... I could barely do better than this. This will put Gian in a safer place, at least. And maybe he might be able to flank someone. That's not great, holy... that was a worse decision. That was definitely a worse decision. At least the truck will probably blow up, but... Alright, let's get it over here. None of them died, but they are revealed, which is something. Alright, Cypher, Leah, you've only got an option to shoot, so I'll just let you do that. I should have kept you behind the full cover. That was terrible. It's the sentry. What's your aim on the drone? 55. I really want that drone down. Oh boy.
Shot wide. Running dry.
This is fun. The moment where everything starts to go wrong. And now it looks like I've screwed Maria over. Maxim, how far is your frag grenade range? Okay, Maxim can kill those three. Please do. Alright, Cypher, what's next? Find me Maria here, she can at least flank that guy.
Good copy. Moving on target.
But while disoriented, she probably won't have much luck. 56, that's not bad actually. Okay, at least Andre won't have to worry about him. Now, Sergey. Which tools of the trade should we use? And how? We can either take out a bunch of people or we can take out a bunch of people, leave the drone. Which, I don't think won't be too bad, so we'll give that a go. I think it's best if we try, if we just center it on as many people as we can. And then at least we'll see what happens. Wish me luck.
Bring in the pain. Multiple threats eliminated.
Okay, that's some eliminated, but not all. And but it's taken some HP out, so could have been better, honestly. All right, is the drone gonna stun or not? Okay, he's gonna stun. That's not such a big deal, but it really depends on how everyone else reacts.
They're all over me.
No, pulling back. Oh, and then running back. All right. So none of them's gonna flank on my range. Oh, which is except the Sectoid. All right. Oh, what are you doing? Oh, he tried to panic already. Already. What are they doing? Okay, this is the best break. This is the best, you know, fresh of air I've had. So reload. Of course, so now that you reload, we can actually holo-target someone. Holo-target the drone, please. Alright, Cypher, you've got a flamethrower and a flashbang remaining. Pardon me, drinking ginger beer, so I felt a burp coming up. These two are on Overwatch, so now Jiang, let's get you over here. You can at least take a shot at the drone, and I basically know full well that you won't be hit by the Overwatch. Oh lordy! All right, Cypher. Wow, they're so far away. Oh, we can hit them with a flashbang. Okay, we'll hit those guys with the flashbang, and then we'll aggressively move forward. Excellent. Leah, you've got a grenade, but I think it's better if you try and take this drone down. I want to move you up, but I don't know where. And then we've got the engineer to worry about as well. Maria. Run and gun up here and knock the Sectoid out. The problem is I don't know if there's still other mobs there, so I'm guessing there isn't, but it's one of those, you know, should I be better safe than sorry kind of thing. Alright, Leo, let's get you over here. I still need to keep you safe in case the Sectoid actually, you know, flanks. Are you kidding me?
Still moving. No rounds.
Alright, well, getting a bit frustrated now. Let's get you up. 65, 35, 35, 34, 20. Finally. Holy shit. I also need to reload soon. So the question is. Okay, I've got these two remaining, Maximilian. I'm gonna move you up and reload. Because we're definitely gonna need your suppression.
We're green to go.
Maria. What's this saying? It's probably you'll be flanked because of the Sectoid. Okay. So run and gun.
Copy that.
Can you stun him? I wonder what happens if I stunned him. Yeah.
Hope this works.
Oh, okay, so he's only just, like, stunned. Not actually, like, you know, we stun and capture them kind of thing. Well, that's not a big deal. We can always just blast him in the face later. Alright, yep, okay, you're gonna flank. That sucks, but. Oh! Alright, okay then. I mean, sure, I'll just... I mean, that doesn't worry me too much, so... Oh, disoriented targets are fun.
Okay, then.
A sectoid on Overwatch, hmm? Alright, Jeff. Who can you take down? Alright, so 53, Cypher. Oh, that sucks. You can't even use any of your... But we can definitely flank them. Oh, I forgot. Well, not like sectoids can hit anyway, but 45, 39. Or 0. Well, we'll take the best. Oh, you're using an SMG. Oh, you still killed him anyway. That works for me. Alright. Jiang? What can you do? You can put a hole or two in that sectoid. No. Yeah, I suppose I don't have to, but may as well. Oh, wrong sectoid. Whoops. Well, Maria, you're taking out the engineer.
Understood. Lower now.
You look. Take a look at that sectoid. Alright. Maria moves up and reloads. Think she can do that. She probably can't throw a grenade yet, so.
Oh, yeah!
Alright, Andre probably can't shoot, so we'll reload.
Oh, yeah.
Well, we can. 32. 49. Yeah, as well. That's something. I mean, I don't like that I'm rolling the dice, but it's one of those. Well, it's the best we can do. So the question is, like, he's probably gonna be out of disoriented next. So what I'm gonna do is suppress him. Oh, I apparently can't see him, but oh, he's disoriented as well. Well, that sucks. Better than nothing. Oh god, more people.
I've got eyes on admin troop.
I mean, I'm not really expecting to be hit, but would have been nice. Oh boy. What is he doing? Oh, another flashbang. I mean, they were kind of disoriented already, so I don't think it... Wow, that sectoid recovered quickly. Ouch. Oh?
No!
Okay.
I wanna go home!
One of the problems is that we've kind of got a no man's... One problem is that we still kind of have a no man's land around here, so it's not gonna be fun, so... Alright, so we've got a bunch of people over there, so we definitely need to pull Maria back. Oh, fudge. Oh, lordy. Time for Jeff to make his move, I guess. Now, Jiang, you're gonna take down that so. I completely forgot about the Overwatch. That's completely my fault. And the sector is apparently not dead. Oh boy. Alright, Leah. You can get much closer.
That's affirmative.
And you can take out that sector if you would so please. It'd be nice if you could take out that one, but this one's definitely much more of it. That's gonna be much more of a problem. I don't need a flashbang yet. Can you...
Let's do this.
36, 34. No, that's not great.
Headed there now.
Alright, we'll get Leo to take out that sectoid.
Grenade out!
Andre, you're in hardcover, so you're probably better off hunkering down. And since you can't really, like, move anywhere important. I guess you could, no, maximally I could move back there. That's really not optimal. Alright, well, we'll move Maximilian back there. Give him a rally watch. Andre. Oh, Jesus.
Rolling out.
We'll let them push forward a bit. Oh, God.
Incoming fire!
She's definitely maybe into full cover next. Oh, okay. I didn't think he could see him from over there, but that's great.
Okay. This is bad.
And he got hit too. Wow. I mean, I suppose it had to happen. Yep. That's expected to happen. So I'm not too bothered. And so I need to pull Maxim back or kill the officer that marked him. Oh God. That's an area suppression as well. That really sucks. But these guys are no longer disoriented. Yay! Alright, you're suppressed, so there's not much I could do about you. Cypher. Kind of just occurred to me I should have called for the Cypher Sky Ranger pretty soon. How much HP do you got? You got 6. I want you to take down the sectoid. Can you please take... Yep. Oh my God, you don't even have the ammo.
It's 1-5. You're near the target position.
Oh boy. Long day. Alright, Jeff. You're gonna move forward and call for the Sky Ranger. So what I wanted to be somewhere like in the middle-ish, that we can kind of just like, but it's close enough to everyone that they can just pull back and run for it when they can.
I need an evac ASAP.
This is Firebrand. Evac request confirmed. Hold tight.
That means. All right, how far can you shoot a grenade? Can you go over there and shoot a grenade for me, or... Andre do that? No, he's got a flashbang. This is also another No Man's Land, which is kind of very irritating as well. I suppose you could suppress a bunch of people. So... I really want to take out that sectoid. Alright, let's see who I can hit with area suppression. Okay, so I need to get closer. Alright, I think I can do that. We'll get you up here.
Position confirmed.
Just hope you don't bloody get hit. I hate that I have to gamble like this. No, not you. I want you to that guy. But apparently that doesn't work either. Because he's too far. Alright. However, you've got... I need to see how many people I have remaining. I've got those two who could take down the zombie if I suppress that guy. So... Alright, I guess area suppression it is. Alright, Jeff, let's get you. I should have equipped you with the pistol. Oh well. Duea or Maxim, what can you do? Your aim is crap, and you're marked as well. So... at this stage, I can actually holo target someone. The question is, who should I holo target? Actually, wait a minute. You said the Overwatch was removed, but I'm still currently suppressed. So, can I just break the suppression by running by moving out? I don't actually know. But let's get Max. I need to pull back this way, I suppose.
Closing on target position now.
Is he still suppressed now? Okay, looks like he's still suppressed, which really sucks. So what I'll do with Jeff is that I'll holo target the zombie and make sure we kill it. Because she's still got 3 turns to bleed out, so this is like such a long mission, holy moly. Alright, Maxim, please kill the zombie. 4 damage, okay, that's something. You still hit it, which is great. Can't really afford to expect too much. Andre, Andre, let's get you over here. That gives you a flank on that guy, which we will take. Oh, hold on, you got 81? Oh, okay. Okay, so damage where Leah is, I think she should take a shot at the zombie while she can. One damage! Oh. God, this is frustrating. Okay, you kill the zombie, please. Alright. Andre, take that flank, you please hit it. Great.
Enemy destroyed.
Oh, this game. Oh, that sucks.
Incoming fire.
He's gonna die. Oh boy. Yeah, I shouldn't have said that.
Evac! We need emergency evac! Now, damn it! Now!
Oh? I mean, that psychotype basically placed himself in flanking territory.
Take a fire over here!
Oh, oh god. How many flashbangs do you have? Oh, he only got those two. That means this guy can still pop up, but that's still ultimately not good. So,
Commander, we're taking heavy losses. We may have to adjust our approach.
Fuck you, Bradford.
Okay.
Hien, you're killing this sectoid. 78. Fuck me.
Kill Katie. Get a closer look.
Leah. Oh, you can still holo target people. So we'll actually do that. So we'll get you to move over there. He's panicked, okay. I kinda just wanna run forward if I can. So But there's literally no cover here because I actually blew it all up, so that's, you know, not the best scenario. I think I'm gonna make Leo run to full cover. Or at least somewhere where others can't, will have a hard time seeing her.
Good to go.
And then that will that gives Cypher the space he needs.
I'm all over it.
Alright, Andre, you can... I have no idea. So, yeah. How long does the Heart of the Tiger remain for? That's what I'm wondering. The other problem is that the med kit might only... I don't remember if the med kit takes a turn. So he's actually going to be out in the open. So we kind of need to aggressively advance if we want to make any actual progress. So what I'm thinking is that I push forward with Andre and actually flashbang this guy. And then that will give us a breather. That will give us all a breather to move forward.
That's affirmative.
I don't like it. It's gotta be done. Oh, that's a flank, but it's not the flank I want. Oh boy. Oh, Jeff, you still have a move. Is there anyone that needs to be smoke grenaded? No. So what we'll do is that we'll holo target someone. Officer, engineer. I want to take out the officer. Or at least, you know, like, if we can take out the officer, we probably should.
I can't move!
Oh god. Marked. Alright, that's fine.
I can't move!
I don't mind the mark so much. It's not that bad, but oh god. 21, Overwatch ready.
Incoming fire!
Alright, they're getting dangerous. Still bleeding out, no longer panning, no longer designed to. Okay, so.
Roger that.
Alright, med kit, stabilize. Do we still have a flashbang remaining? I would love to have a flashbang remaining. Okay, you have potential for good flanks, very very good flanks, but I don't want you to make a run for it yet. I'm gonna risk this one. All right, 45. That's pretty good. Alright, 61, 61, 61. They're all 61s. Who do I want to take out? Who can she take out in one hit? So... oh god, I don't even know. I'll take out the Sentry, because the Sentry is the one that goes on Overwatch. 3 damage, oh my goodness. Chang. Where can you? I don't want you to get too close either, but it might be too risky for you to push forward in that way. All right. I want him to go there and shoot him because he's got a flank, but I need to ensure I can actually take him out. So he's got a frag. So okay, that settles it. The only problem is that he might actually get flanked that way, which really sucks. Great. Now Maximilian can actually move anywhere closer unless he actually moves over here, which is not good, but it's still closer. The other problem is that oh what? I did not want him to do that. Oh my fucking god. Okay, right, so there's one on Overwatch, so I'm just gonna repeat the moves I did last time. So I did Leo move over here. And from memory, she didn't. This time she gets hit, which is kind of wow. So, and I went for the sentry.
Good riddance.
But at least she killed him this time, which is something. And I think, yeah, I forgot to do the moves in the order I did them before, so I actually had Jeff go over here and revive her first.
Nothing's broken. You're fine.
Yep, this one's on me. Jiang, so I'll probably get you up here and then we'll take a shot, but let's deal with this guy first. Alright, take a shot.
I skirted him. Ammo out.
Yep, okay, that's exactly what happened before. Now, this is the place where I made the mistake. And of course I need to figure out how I'm gonna handle this. Part of the problem is that he's the only one currently active with the flashbang as well. Let's see how far I can hit with the flamethrower again. So if I go straight forward, is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tiles. So if I go here, there'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So he'll only hit that guy. And over here he'll be in low cover as well, which is not great, but I think at this point we kind of need to be a bit more aggressive. So I guess
heading to that location.
No, let's go with that, because I've already put Andre in danger. I need to take him out of danger. Just gotta make sure I don't hit. Oh lordy.
Bombs away.
I'll bet you that won't kill him. Actually, I shouldn't make any bets or anything like that. Okay, great. Jiang. You got 3 out of 4 health, which really means I really don't want to get you any closer into action. But we have such a good opportunity here.
Rolling.
We'll still keep you further away. I really don't like this, but I think it's more important to. Oh, the problem is you can't even kill them, unless you crit, which actually that works. Oh, she crit for 5. Didn't even. All right, and then what are you gonna do?
Sure thing.
And Thor. Yes. No. Maybe. Oh, if only you could hit both of them. You're gonna hunker down. Alright, so that's that. Oh god. Oh, you're doing a flashbang. That's fine, actually. Because the flashbang basically means he's not taking a shot, and oh crap, they're flanked. Well, he can take a shot at least. As long as it's not a critical. And he. Nope, that's not a flank. Alright, so Cypher. Maximilian. And then Leah, and then Andre. Andre, can you flank this guy? Yes, you can. Well. Actually, no, you can't. You can go here. But how are we going to deal with this guy? That's the question. So, we got Jeff. At this stage, I'm pretty sure this is all that's remaining. So, we'll get Cypher up to torch that guy, I suppose. But we need to think about this guy. So, Leah, let's get you pulled back.
Good copy. Moving on target.
And see if you can get anything out of that flanking shot.
Enemy down.
Oh, that's my girl. Alright, that makes life a lot easier. Jang?
Order's confirmed.
Actually, you know what? You're gonna pick up this and then you're gonna pull back. Are you even picking this up? Well, okay. I'm a bit dismayed, but that's how it is, I suppose. We should play this safe, but at this stage, given how long we've been taking so far, I'm in this whole, you know, fuck it kind of mood. Okay, 4 on burning, that means he'll die next turn. So, question is, how do we deal with that guy? Do we go fuck it and... Yep, okay, may as well. You... That's my mistake. I'm not resetting that one. Holy moly. It's just one of those days, huh?
Light 'em up.
Jim, why can't you? Okay, we'll pull you back. That's just a hilarious mistake on my end. Jeff. The utility man. Yeah, sure, why not? You can kind of tell at this stage, I'm just like, I've just stopped caring. Alright, yes! Oh my goodness.
We're not picking up any inbound contacts. Scanners are clear. -15, we have a limited window to act before Advent responds. We need to get those charges planted on the double.
On my way.
Let's pick up that loot. So Xiang couldn't pick up the loot before because she was disoriented. That makes sense. Superior hacking. All right, let's plant the X4 and let's get out of here.
-15, rendezvous at the extraction point. Status confirmed. Squad is clear. Detonating charges.
That was a long, long mission. So one dead, that was a ranger, and one kill, soldiers wounded, rating acceptable. I mean, I like to think I did pretty well, especially for a Fortified, and especially given how many mobs that we had to deal with in one go, but there were definitely mistakes I made that certainly needs a bit of reflection on, and to, I guess, really rein in for some tactics, strategies, just to keep in mind, just to make sure that it doesn't happen next time. But with 4 injured, you know, we're gonna have a fairly injured roster, so hopefully, well, not so hopefully. as people say, that's long, and much rather that's long war, and we just gotta roll with the punches. Alright, Zhang, you've got a promotion. Needle grenade to explosives do not destroy loot. Nah, I don't need that. Give me this. Nope, we need Sapper. Thank you. Killed in action. Lightly wounded. Just running gun now. Yeah, after I disorient the target when he misses, so and then slug shot. What's the slug shot again? Shot that pierces 2 armor and has no range. Penalty uses 2 ammo, 3 turn cooldown, or lightning reflexes. I still need my lightning reflexes. I think it definitely makes life a lot easier. Jeff, trying to think about what kind of guy you are. You got 4 health, 80 aim, which is pretty good. It's really either rapid targeting or death from above. And I'm just trying to think. I guess the question is, like, how useful do I find rapid targeting? So, but then if I have death from above and I kill someone, then I can use the holoid thing. But the question is, how many chances will I get to actually kill someone with the sniper? That's the question. So I'm gonna go for rapid targeting. It's still, you know, it's kind of like a more supporty skill that is, I think is more important. So that it's pretty hard to say. But anyway, so Miss Shops' primary version have an additional role to become a Graze. For the other guy, we got sent to Mass, so I will try Grazing Fire with this one. And then we'll see what happens. Alright, continue. Whew, 16 days, that's gonna suck. Okay, looks like we got our replacement Ranger, as much as I hate to say it. Demon Grenadier works for me. Superior hacking, plus 13 hacking, and advanced entry 10. Bonus aim on reaction fire shot. Sorry, definitely. HQ for new recruits. Indeed, we should. I wonder if there's a way to actually. Let's recruit. No recruits available. Memorial squad management? No, that's not what I want. There was an option to actually check the resistance management. There we go. No, I remember one particular guy actually having. So could I actually move him into? It'd be nice if I could make him a rookie, but I guess I won't complain too much. All right, I'm exhausted. Force under strain, low intel. We can't really recruit anyone at the moment, so I guess we gotta keep pushing forward. So we're here. I'm now like trying to think. Okay, what have we done? What do we need to do? So. We'll keep doing that. Hello. Ready intel, destroy the alien relay. Okay. 2 days, 4 hours, so... we can either do this with a shinobi, or we can do this with a single assault. And I have a feeling a shinobi is probably best. And maybe we bring a shotgun? Or... I guess a shotgun isn't necessary, so 2 days, 4 hours, 2 days, 18 hours. That sucks, actually. I wonder if I could remove the... No, let's remove those and see how she does. 2 days, 18 hours up, so the ability to gear modifier won't really do much. Can we equip the SMG with the suppressor? We've got actually quite... okay. Reduces the soldier's impact on mission infiltration time. We have an SMG with a suppressor that's actually pretty neat. 2 days, 6... actually, no. We could replace the hunter's axe with the basic sword. Does that affect it? No. Okay, so the question is how do we deal with this one now? So, I'm going to go with the flashbang. Do we have the nanoscale vest? No, we don't. So we're going to go with ceramic plating, and she will no doubt be... because the other thing is that it's only dirty intel, so it doesn't feel like it's worth it to really spend... yeah, it doesn't feel like it's really worth it to spend intel on this one. So this will be a so-so. We'll pull out. We will pull her out if we need to. And but for now, I think that's the best we can do. I was thinking the other thing I could do, maybe putting a technical and have him, you know, fire using Roxas or something, but we'll give this a spin, and since it's one person, it shouldn't be too bad, in the sense that we can always just call the Sky Ranger and pull back if we need to. The other thing I don't know is how much health the relay has, So that's definitely going to be something we'll check out and just see what happens. Alright, training, he's done. George is back, hooray! Alright, so you got Executioner and Smoker. Looks like the Advanced Warfare abilities doesn't really discriminate, so it's kind of just like still randomish. Alright, what was I thinking? Oh, I need to train someone else in the Advanced Warfare setup. Train soldiers with AWC abilities. Alright, let's put George back into the team. What can Jeff train? While concealed, gain 50 bonus aim, 50 bonus critical hit chance when attacking enemies. That would be nice if he's like the first one to take a shot. That would be really good. So we'll keep that in the back of our head. We'll just check out the others. Maximilian, the gunner. Ghostwalk is pretty good. Cross shot once. Execution is pretty good for Maximilian. What else can George learn? Bring him on. Cross shot. Equip matches have 2 extra charges. I mean, given that I've been giving matches to George, it could be useful. I don't want to put my technical into training. I can't afford to. Lightning hands, will to survive, that's not great. So I think I'm gonna go for the gunner with executioner. Because the aim boost is really nice. Okay, once that's clear, we'll have a bunch of supplies, and the supplies will be really nice for building our training center. So be definitely be looking forward to that.
I assure you'll find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Alright, Illyrium Crystals, very welcome. Now we should actually do research. So I was thinking, I was probably saying before the sectoid autopsy is next, or the resistance radio. But it's like we don't need the resistance radio now, so we're gonna go for the sectoid autopsy.
Though I was never witness
and here we
to
need
one
two
myself.
Okay.
Countless observers attest to the existence of a much smaller, less intimidating variant of the sectoid that took part in the original invasion. In the time since, this new being, the product of clear genetic manipulation, is now a familiar face to our forces operating in the field.
I don't like the squelchy sounds. It's like, oh god, what's he touching there?
The Avenger. I'm never going to.
Okay, moving on. Hello. Cover an item from the Advent train, find a lead, 27 intel. 2 days, 13 hours. So here we've got to recover an item from an Advent train. If it's recovering an item, then I'm just trying to think, if it's recovering an item from an Advent train, it's probably like, you know, we might need someone to hack the door, it'd be nice if we had a specialist. But we honestly don't have enough of our store at the moment. Might need, also given that this is 27 intel, we don't have that much time. I think this is a mission we're gonna have to give a miss. Because we can't really put one person in, and we can't just throw 4 people, especially 2 sharpshooters, so we're gonna ignore that one, unfortunately. Alright. Hello. Great. View the room. Oh, we really need that Kuyala Tactics School. Okay, we should clear out another room. That'll be very nice. So 63. Hopefully take a 1 bit more. 15 days. It's gonna take a while. Thankfully we've got a supply drop coming soon, so I'll be looking forward to those supplies. And then alright, so finally we've got this particular one, which was the squad. Yeah, just a single guy. So single, well, it's Paulina. Boost infiltration. Yeah, it's 25 intel, which is, I mean, we're getting a reward 30 intel, so I feel like this is good enough. But if we say enemy readiness is guarded, then we'll just have to see what happens. And if that doesn't work, then we just have to play it safe. So yeah. This was a long video. This was a very that fight was very long, but I'm glad that mostly everyone came out alive. A lot of injury, not so great. Definitely some mistakes I made and will improve on in future, hopefully. But yeah, so look forward to the next video, Operation Nightfall, which will obviously be a sneaky mission and no doubt a short video as well. And so as always, thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next video.